I remember learning about the Imagination Library in Southwest Washington through our County United Way and our Rotary Clubs, and instantly became a huge fan. A way to prepare our children for school and an activity that we can do together as a family. And I think that, to me, is the best part of Dolly Parton's Imagination Library. Not only does it prepare our children for school, but it helps build more connected families. I'm sure many of you know the book, The Coat of Many Colors, a book written by and about Dolly Parton herself. In it, she describes how her mother, of little financial means, sewed colorful patches together to make a coat of many colors. And while others may not have been able to see the richness in that coat or the richness in her family, it made Dolly the person she is today, and we're so thankful for that. But like those colorful patches, we as families, as parents, reading these books, sew stories, sew memories together, and we create richness, and we build character within our children. The Dolly Parton Imagination Library is so much more than just the Imagination Library. It's an integral part to helping end intergenerational poverty by building stronger families, by building stronger communities, and by building a stronger Washington. On behalf of everyone here and everyone watching and everyone who's participated in this program, I want to thank you for your continued support of our families and our children in Washington and your support for Dolly Parton's Imagination Library. Thank you very much.
Dolly Parton, ladies and gentlemen.
Yeah, do that. Okay, move this one back a little. Okay, I think I'm ready. So I'm sure a lot of you know this little song. It's a story about my mom. Now, I told you about my dad, because I was lucky enough to have a good mom and daddy. As hard as it was and as hard as they had it, they never seemed to complain. They loved us all, and Mama, she was one of those people that could sew anything, make it look good, tell you anything, make it sound good, cook anything, make it taste good. She was just one of those mamas. But she made me this little coat that I've become famous for, really. We made a little movie out of it a few years back. You might have seen it on NBC. They show it around Christmas time. But anyway, it's like this little story. It just kind of lives on. It's just about love, acceptance, and just kind of what I was just talking about before, trying to just be a little nicer to people and loving people for who they are. So anyhow, I hope you'll enjoy the little coat of many colors, and it goes like this. Turn the guitar up a little. Back through the years, I go wandering once again. Back to the seasons of my youth. And I recall a box of rags someone gave us. And how my mama put the rags to use. There were rags of many colors, but every piece was small. I didn't have a coat, and it was way down in the fall. Mama sewed the rags together, so in every piece with love, she made my coat of many colors that I was so proud of. While Mama sewed, she told a story from the Bible she had read about a coat of many colors Joseph wore, and then she said, I hope this coat will bring you good luck and happiness, and I just couldn't wait to wear it, and Mama blessed it with a kiss. My coat of many colors that my Mama made for me, made only from rags, but I wore it so proudly. And although we had no money, I was rich as I could be. In my coat of many colors Mama made for me. So with patches on my breeches, holes in both my shoes, in my coat of many colors, I hurried off to school. just to find the others laughing and making fun of me in my coat of many colors Mama made for me. And oh, I couldn't understand that, 'cause I felt I was rich, and I told them of the love Mama sewed in every stitch. I even told them all the story Mama told me while she sewed, and why my coat of many colors was worth more than all their clothes. They didn't understand it, and I tried to make them see. One is only poor, only if they choose to be. It's true we had no money, but I was rich as I could be in my coat of many colors Mama made for me, 'cause she made it just for me.
You know, it is my belief that if you happen to have a good mom and daddy, that is one of the greatest gifts that God can bestow on you. Wouldn't you agree with that? Now, some people are not that lucky, but I was. And I think back on my folks a lot. I often am just sorry that mom and daddy ain't around today to see all the good things that's happened to me in my life. And I appreciate them, because so much of it had to do with them. And anyhow, I always think of them, and every time I talk about Daddy, about the coat of many colors, I mean the Imagination Library, sing this little song about Mama, it always keeps home in my heart. And that's one of the things that saved me as an entertainer and artist, because some people kind of run off the rails somewhere along the way, because they maybe didn't have that kind of a grounding and that sort of a upbringing. But I can always go home in my mind, no matter where I am or what I'm going through. I always just think of home, and I'm always feeling a little better about that. Anyway, I want to sing you another song now. This is a song, when I put the Imagination Library together and it started to do good, I thought, well, every program needs to have some sort of a theme song. And you know me, I'm good about writing songs. So I thought, well, what will I write this about? And I thought, well, I'll write it kind of about myself. I'll write it about people like me and people like you that really know that we need to try. No matter what it is we're up against, no matter how bad things seem to be in our lives, and of course we do all have a lot of burdens to carry. We all have a lot of problems, especially in this day and time. It's hard to know hardly what to do, ain't it? But anyhow, I thought, well, I've always tried, no matter what else happened, I've always tried to do my best. And I thought, well, that'll be a good theme song, just try. So that's what this one's called. And I hope, as my mama would say, I hope you get a blessing out of it. Okay, it goes like this. I have chased after rainbows, I've captured one or two. I've reached for the stars, and I have even held a few. I've walked that lonesome valley, topped the mountains, soared the sky. I've laughed and I've cried, but I have always tried, 'cause I've always been a dreamer, and dreams are special things. But dreams are of no value if they're not equipped with wings. So secure yourself for climbing, make ready for the sky. Don't let your chance go by. You'll make it if you try. So try to be the first one up the mountain, the highest flying dreamer in the sky. And try your best to be an
So try each day to try a little harder. And if you fail, give up and try again. You know, nothing is impossible if you can just believe. Don't live your life in shackles when faith can be the key. The winner's one that keeps determination in his eyes, who's not afraid to fly and not afraid to try. So try to be the first one up the mountain and try to be the first to touch the sky. And don't let somebody tell you you can't do it. And if they say that, show them it's a lie. You'll never really know if you don't try. And the first step is the one that's always hardest. But you'll never really know if you don't try.
Thanks for coming, and thanks for all your help. And let's just get more books in the hands of more children. How's that?